Hey guys, what is going on location out here in Bodrum, Turkey, and today we are taking a look at one of the most beautiful cities I have ever been to. Thank you for joining me out here in Bodrum, Türkiye. And originally this place wasn't even on my radar. A lot of you guys left comments, messaged me on Instagram and told me to come here. There was even a waiter in Bursa who wrote on a piece of paper when he found out I did YouTube videos, Bodrum. He's like, go there. And so here I am. I got a little bit of time to check this city out. And so far I am very impressed. We're going to start out a little bit differently today. We are going to check out the views from up there. So we're going to head over there, make sure, subscribe, give this video a like, and stay locked in. We got a lot to see out here. So long time ago, Bodrum was the Greek city of Halicarnassus. And these here are the city walls. So you can see it's up on the hill, protecting it from anybody coming in from the Aegean Sea. So you may be wondering what these are. These are a few remaining windmills from the 18th century. Were used for grinding flour, and they would take advantage of the wind coming off the Aegean and Mediterranean seas, which is cool, but it's only half the reason I came up here. I wanted to see a view of the city, because from the bottom, holy cow, it looked really nice. Wow, look at this place. This is incredible. See the castle down there, the marina. A lot of stuff to explore. Looking out over the city, you can tell that the paint stores only sell one color. But man, it looks gorgeous. You might be able to hear the wind blowing in this microphone. It's pretty strong up here, meaning it's a good place for windmills. So they got a lot of flour out of these, but they are no longer in use. All right, we made it down here to sea level. Got the marina and a nice street with a lot of pubs, cafes, restaurants. Take a nice little stroll on a day like today after parking your yacht or boat right here. Castle is across the way there. That's where we're headed. My boat is parked. I can't really see it from here, but you have to trust me. I came by boat. It looks like a pirate ship. All these places have to be white. I guess they've got a pretty strict homeowners association. And the Starbucks, completely white. This is a nice little promenade here. If you make it out here, very relaxing trip. not exactly sure what this is across the street, but looks a bit expensive. Hope it doesn't rain. I wonder if they take it in if it rains or cover it somehow. So this is where we were before. You can kind of see on this hilltop. You can see the windmills. Walked all the way down here. Even more enormous, impressive boats. And right next to the castle. I didn't know that you could park this close. Otherwise, I would have parked my boat right in this spot here. I think that would be, might be big enough for my boat. But, you know, I got to exercise, walk around a little bit, and here we are. Wow, look at this place. So, as somebody takes my parking spot, I'll tell you a little bit about Bodrum Castle here. It's also known as Castle of St. Peter. It was built in 1402 by the Knights of St. John. I'm not exactly sure how it works, but I do know that inside there is car, the Museum of Underwater Archaeology. Well, it seems like the Underwater Archaeology Museum and the castle are kind of just one and the same. So you buy the ticket to get into the Underwater Museum, and then you also get to check out the castle. Got a lot of history, as you'd expect. During the Ottoman Empire, this was actually a prison. And in World War I, this castle was bombed by the French and taken over by the Italians until Mustafa Kemal Atatürk was successful and kicked them out. These cannons here from the 18th and 19th centuries, Ottoman Empire. It would not be awesome to get hit by one of these. Here's another nice view of the marina. So back this way is the Aegean Sea. Bodrum is kind of in the middle. If we look out this way, it's the Mediterranean Sea. Got a cool view of the castle. Across this bridge, these are all altars from the Hellenistic period. Now this would work as it would go in a family cemetery and they would make offerings on it. They'd put maybe fruit and bread or do an animal sacrifice and gather around and play the flute or dance and celebrate the ancestors. See these cool reliefs that have lasted the test of time. Look at this thing. Here's another one. I don't really know about peacocks, so I don't know if it's bleached or albino or supposed to look like that. I guess it matches with the houses and buildings here in Bodrum. All right, continue. Whoa, look at this. I'd like to think that whoever made that, they just put their own head on top. It's like a self-portrait. They always wanted to be an animal, so maybe they made their dream come true. It has come to my attention that the 500 lira I paid to get in is only to get into the castle. If I want to see this shipwreck exhibition, it's another 130, but I do want to see this. Well, I was wrong. The 500 lira ticket did cover this. And I usually don't film in museums, because that's kind of cheating, but this is kind of an interesting thing. It was all found in the sea. Like that. The cool thing is they have a whole ship that was shipwrecked. So what is left of this ship has kind of been put into this frame here. And this ship is thought to have sank in 1026 AD. It was a Byzantine era ship. It was bringing glass from a port in Syria. They believe that it was a Bulgarian ship, or Bulgarians, current day Bulgarians, were piloting the ship, and it sank due to an anchor failure. They were able to get some of the pottery. I don't know if this is all the glass that they found. Here we have a courtyard full of statues, and none of them have a head. I guess the head's probably the easiest thing to break off if the statue falls over, or you just have a bunch of people that enjoy beheading statues. This whole castle is kind of a museum, which makes sense why they charged it at the entrance. And then there are a couple stops for different shipwrecks that have been excavated underwater. I don't know why I always think this is funny. I've seen this a lot. Thirth? Is that a third? Yeah, it cracks me up sometimes. What do we got? In the Thirth Bailey. Just in case you missed it earlier, more stunning views of the city. Bodrum. Man. All right. We're gonna do it again. What's this one? What do you call it? Tooth Bailey? Yep. I bet there's gonna be an awesome view up there. Well, this door is locked, so they're not allowing people to go up. Still looks very nice. Still offers some great views. We are a bit deeper into the city now, but don't you worry. There are still some sites that need to be visited. Here we are. This is great. Might not look like much now, but it used to be wonderful. So wonderful that this was one of the seven ancient wonders of the world. Right here. This isn't the first one that we've seen on this YouTube channel or even in Turkey, but today in Bodrum, we are checking out the Mausoleum of Halicarnassus. So who was this enormous structure built for? It was built for Mausolus. If you think it's weird that Mausolus sounds like mausoleum, well, Mausolus was not named after a mausoleum. Mausoleums were named after Mausolus because of this structure here. Luckily, I'm ahead of this field trip. So Mausolus was a Persian who was a king of these parts. And the mausoleum that was constructed for him here was 45 meters high, which is about 150 feet. So pretty enormous. All right, it looks like this is a place where we can actually go down into the Mausoleum of Halicarnassus. And remember, Halicarnassus was the Greek name of this city before it was Bodrum. So here we are. We are in the wonder. A lot of pillars, and it was eventually destroyed in the Middle Ages by an earthquake. There are a lot of earthquakes in Asia Minor, in this part of the world. This would be the tomb chamber here. So Mausolus and his wife were buried right here a long, long time ago. This cat has been meowing at me for a while. Something wrong? What's wrong? Are you welcoming me to the mausoleum? When this was first built, the structure and sculptures were made by a lot of the best artists of the time. And it was said to have been influenced by Greek, Egyptian, and Lycian cultures and art. A lot of the surviving sculptures are still available to see in London. So I guess we won't see them here. But it is a pretty cool feeling to stand around in one of the ancient wonders of the world. That's a bit strange, as I had a cat meowing at me back when I was at the Temple of Artemis. One of the ancient wonders. You can just reach out and touch it. It's pretty cool. So, I don't know, these cats, maybe they are the protectors of the seven ancient wonders of the world. But just like the Temple of Artemis, it's a cool feeling to just reach out and touch one of the ancient wonders. Well, here we can see kind of where we are. There's the castle, and number four there is the mausoleum where we are. And here's an actual model of what it would have looked like. Absolutely gigantic, this thing. Man. So, yeah, seeing that from a distance, they must have really liked Mausolus. Oh, here it is once more. The Mausoleum of Halicarnassus from 350 BC. And I just found out that after it was destroyed in the earthquake, a lot of the stones from this mausoleum went into the construction of the Bodrum Castle that we were just in. So in a sense, we were kind of walking around the Mausoleum of Halicarnassus already. Interesting. Antique Teatro. I don't mind if I do. So this is Bodrum Ancient Theater, built in the 4th century BC during the Hellenistic period, and then got revamped a bit by the Romans. Originally, it could seat 10,000 people. You can see some of the seating in the upper bowl there. It's been kind of worn away, so now it can seat 4,000 people. And this is actually still used today for concerts and plays and events. This isn't the first ancient theater that we've seen, but it is still very cool to come here. And it's awesome to know that these still get used, or at least some of them do. You can come out here with your friends, listen to Gulat Sarpas sing Ask Bodrum Daya Senyor, and jam out, or watch a play, or, you know, just hang out like I'm doing. You might be strolling along the street in Bodrum, turn into a park, and then see this. This is Myndos Gate. It's one of two entrances and exits into the ancient city of Halicarnassus. It was built by our buddy Mausolus in the 4th century BC. And one of the really cool things about this gate and the surrounding area is that a lot of battles took place right here when Alexander the Great took over the ancient city Halicarnassus. Because this was one of only two ways to get into the city, because the rest of it was boarded up by the city walls, this was a very important and one of the most difficult areas for Alexander the Great. I'm actually up here on Myndos Gate, which I don't know, you could come up here. I'm sure there's a great view. I can't see it. Maybe you guys can see it.
Oh, yeah. I hope so.
There's a nice view off the side here. I didn't really know what to expect coming out to Bodrum. A lot of people, like I said, told me to come out here, and now I see why. This is a very stunning city right on the water. Well, that is it for this episode. You know me, I got a bus to catch onto the next place, but I've really enjoyed this city. Give it a like, subscribe. I'd love to see you guys in the next episode, because that is where I'm heading.